guys, welcome to a new video. Today I will be showing you guys how to play Lux. Lux is that utility mage type of champion which mainly focuses on peeling her allies in teamfights and bursting down a single target unit. Now you want to max out your E ability because it's your main poke tool pre level 6 and it's also helpful for clearing out waves. And then you max out your Q second because it's your root ability, so you want to have that on a low cooldown as well, and then you double your last. That's your shield, but it's not what we will be prioritizing in the laning phase. So when you play Lux in the early game, she has pretty high cooldowns, but her passive is quite useful because whenever you hit an opponent with an ability, they will have this kind of flight mark on them, and then you can proc it with your auto attacks to deal bonus damage. Just like this here. That's what you want to abuse in the laning phase to get maximum amount of damage off. So we are playing against the Heimer. He's pretty obnoxious of course in the laning phase because he can push really fast. So you want to mainly play it up passive, don't push too much because even though we are long range, quite safe. We are still immobile, so if we end up getting ganked, then it's pretty doomed. Because that will almost always result in us losing our summoner spells or just getting killed. So yeah, the early laning phase will of course be tough against the Heimerdinger. That's normal. So just focus on getting the CS you can, but the most important thing is getting the XP. So you can stay relevant XP wise, of course. We don't have the mana to just spam abilities just yet, so want to chill for a bit until we get the Lost Chapter, then we can play more aggressive. He has the resolve secondary as well, so quite defensive with the bone plating, so whenever we go for all ins and stuff, we want to make sure that it's procced first, maybe with an auto attack. Okay, why is it a bot side? I need to warn my teammates. When you try to warn teammates, don't just press the missing ping, just press it, spam the danger ping on top of them if possible. Because that increases the chances of them actually noticing the pings. And in the end it might end up saving their lives, so overall it's pretty good. Let's see if I can hit her. There we go, that should be a kill, right? Awesome. Okay, he's helping me clearing the turrets, that's good. I can't really do much early though because I don't have the mana for it. Oh, he got the flash as well. Great. He has no flash, so there we go. That should also be a kill. I don't want to use my barrier just yet. Oh, that's a three-man gang. That is awesome. Great. Great coordination from my team. So the wave clear early on is obviously not that good because of her cooldowns. Alright, we can base. Now we have the Lost Chapter, so we can do a bit more in the laning phase. Her abilities also cost a lot of mana, especially the E, so you want to be careful not spamming that too much in the early laning phase, because then you'll run Noom and you'll be forced to base. So getting this refillable potion, it's very cost efficient. You never have to buy pots ever again, and you can also sell it later on, so you get some of the gold back. So overall it's extremely cost efficient, especially if you get the Dark Seal afterwards as well. Just spam ping like this, so you make sure that your teammates see your pings. Some people do get annoyed by it of course, and if that's the case then just ping normally, but I always use this spam ping just to make sure that everybody sees what's happening on the map. Oh, the cannon bro, okay. So now we do have the ult, so we can burst down our targets. We can also use it to clear waves. Wait, why is he ping? Oh, he's not here yet. Okay, they're coming. You can use the E to slow, right? Okay, he should be there. I don't want to waste my ult unless it's very necessary. Okay, that's good. I can save that one. My team just wants to do the stream and ganks over and over. It's awesome. The thing is, if you have enough experience with Lux, you can use your autos before your ability goes off, so you get a guaranteed passive proc like this here. I autoed immediately, so it gives that kind of instant damage. And then you can back off, so your opponent can't really counter it. See here, we want to get those tower plates, of course, and then focus on taking down his turrets, which we can do now, because we have enough mana and damage. Okay, why is up here? He's level 4, it's okay for now. Tryndamere is invading. Yeah, saw him. Just very easily like this. If I need to help him. Just slowing for a bit. Lux really start shining when you have wait, I might be able to kill this guy. There we go. Shield this guy as well. I hope he doesn't have flash, that would be really bad for us. Okay, seems like he does not have it. Okay, he does have it. Okay, we got the kill. It's fine, it's not too bad. So Lux really starts shining when you have your core items, which is a Luden Seiko and then a Morel Nomicon or a Rabadon's Deathcap. So you get the, you always get this one, the Oblivion Orb, and then if they have a lot of healing, then you upgrade it to Morel Nomicon already immediately. But if they don't have healing, then just buy this one and then proceed to a Rabadon's Deathcap. Here, gonna get this one and then get some vision. Vision is good. I'm just gonna buy two control wards in case somebody comes mid to clear it. So we got the flash from this guy. He's pretty huge though. It's not very good because he's stomping our top laner. He has CDR boots, which are kind of questionable. Oh, Darius is roaming, but okay, that's a 4-man gank, possibly a 5-man gank. He does not have flash, but I'm gonna move down as well in case they might try to dive my teammates. Okay, they are. This looks like it's going to fail from them. It's a very questionable game. Oh, he dodged it. Okay. It does have a bit of a delay. I'm gonna use it to slow. I don't use it immediately, like this here. There we go. Yours does have a bit of delay, so if your opponents have vision on you, then it's of course hard to land it. Might be waiting around here, isn't he? Gonna save my shield. Okay, he's not. It's really hard to push lanes this early in the game because you don't have a lot of damage. Remember that your shield will shield your allies twice. First when you use it and then when it returns again. So make sure to aim it so it actually hits your allies twice. So now that Y is probably level 6, we want to be really careful. There you go, clear out stress and then just back off. I have my ult up again. In the late game it will be on a really low cooldown, so you can just spam it on waves and stuff, so you can push really fast. Okay, we got his flash, Y is coming. This is really good. Great room from Thresh. I might be able to beta, maybe. Let's see him. Vi is probably around here still. that's not good. We got baited. Oh, that's not very good. Maybe they might be able to get by. Okay. It's not the best, but it's alright. We have the Drake and we also want the next one, the ocean. So the third one can potentially be the Cloud Drake, which gives cooldown reduction on your ultimate. That one is really OP on champions who have high cooldown on the ultimate, like Karthus. It's also pretty good on Lux. So you get even lower CD on your ult. Let's see here. It's not gonna cover the entire spot, so I won't use it here. Okay, see here, they're probably doing the I can imagine they want to do the Drake. There we go. Bam. Always try to combine your ultimate with your Q. And if you have a difficult time hitting your Q, then use your E first, because the zone will slow any opponents in it, so it makes it easier for you to hit your skill shots. Normally I would like to have a stopwatch against the Vi and diving champions, but it's really bad against Caitlyn, because you can just put a trap on top of the hourglass and then you die either way, so it's probably a bit of a waste of gold here. I do have my flash up, but I don't see Vi on the map, so I can't really walk that far up yet. Just poke him like this. He has he rushed tier 2 boots, which is really smart against skill shot matchups like Lux. It's easier for him to dodge skill shot and stuff. Top lane is not looking good at all. Oh, he's going AP Tryndamere, that's why I was wondering. That's not a lot of damage. See if I can cancel his base here. Okay. There's a cannon wave coming in. He also saw Vi headed bot side. The thing is, Heimer is within kill range. I just need to land a skill shot and he's dead. But I need to watch out for Darius, which is missing on the map. Okay, he's back now. Vi is still missing. Caitlyn is coming mid. Okay, they're all grouping mid apparently. If they are, then I'll just ult the wave. There we go. Nice. That's very good. Oh, Braum blocked it. That's a little bit unfortunate. Okay, I canceled his base. I'm just gonna back off now because I had a lot of gold. I can get my tier 2 boots and then a blasting wand. I want to be efficient with the gold, so I'm gonna buy the most expensive thing, that is the blasting wand. So whenever there's an ADC in the game, they will of course have a lot of healing, because they usually run the healing rune in the precision tree. I believe it's called bloodline or something. Let's see here. So my team scales really well, because we have an Ashe and a Mundo. That's when he has his items, he can just straight up run into the enemy team alone and just be annoying, while we can peel him a lot with our shields and root. So that's what we're aiming for, is those 5 versus 5 group team fights. Okay, we got his Barry and Flash. It's awesome. Pretty good. Time that for my teammate. There we go. Get some proper vision here. When you place the blue trinket, try to place it in the spot where they want. Just clear out immediately, because when you place it here, people often just run past it without noticing it. So try to find those good spots where it can survive the longest. I have mauled up soon. Can hit. Oh, this looks nice. Oh, Braum saved her again. There we go. Oh, that's a double kill. That's awesome. That's why I like this ult. And it also has a extremely low cooldown. Well, there's nobody bot side to defend. Or top side. Darius also has a lot of healing, so Royal Nomicon does make sense in this game. Seems like Tryndamere is tilted, possibly. I can't really walk within range because he will just kill me, so. Okay, he's dead though, I think, right? Oh, he heals for a lot. Damn, okay. We got the kill, but Tryndamere, I don't know what he's doing. But we want to get this one. Gonna get the Morel Nomicon, so it makes it a bit easier to kill Darius. Aye, we got the cannon in. Okay. We need to swap so our bot lane goes top side. Because they can deal with Darius. He's pretty easy to kite for an Ashe, as long as they count his summoners. Okay, let's go, let's do it. I'm gonna get a ward here. I'm gonna shield him. Use the E to zone like this. You can zone opponents away from objectives. There we go, it's awesome. Now we can take this Drake now. Cause their ADC is down, so they don't really have that take this one. Wait, where's Ashe going? I'm just gonna zone her like this and then we focus on taking the Drake. Attack this one, guys, please. Cause we have two Drakes. This one will be the third and then we can unlock the Mountain Soul. That is the extremely OP one. Oh, that's not good. Darius got his if he gets this full passive off, we just need to run away. Cause he's just gonna heal for a ton. Okay, we got a shutdown. We are getting something at least. I might die here still though, cause this passive deals a lot of damage. Okay, I survive, but I need to stay out of Kate ult range. Okay, it's fine, we got his ult. I can't really do anything here, cause he might just ult me and then I die, so. They don't have MR yet, so that means we can buy more AP. Gonna sell the drone string for another large rod. Here, what's so now only infernal spawn, which is really good. Those are incredibly strong, especially the ocean soul or the infernal soul. Awesome, there we go. Legendary status, so I need to stay very careful in fights because I give a lot of gold, 700 gold to have whoever kills me. We want to group mid and then get the turret here. Always play for the objectives. And then don't activate your E immediately, but use it to zone like this. Good thing is he can't block my ult with his shield, so yeah, there is that. I have my ult up in 25 seconds, so it has an extremely low cooldown, which is really good for those team fights, because it deals a lot of damage, especially when I'm fed. Darius we need to be very careful of. Okay, good, he missed his hook. That's his way of engaging, so if he misses it then you can play more aggressive. We need to back off here because I have my Rabidon's death cap. They are buying MR now, but Darius is not my main target. My main targets are the squishy ones, because if I catch either of them then I can just ult and finish them off. Alright, let's go, we just need to group as 5. Possibly 4, because Strinderman needs to be on the side lane, but he can't really 1v1 Darius at all. Especially not with this build. It's like some kind of AP hybrid build. I know he heals for a lot. Want to stay grouped? I'm not going solo anywhere, because I am immobile, so if they catch me out, then I'm dead. I can one-shot his turret, so that's even better. Let's move up to Tryndamere. We want to be careful in those spots here, because we are against the Heimerdinger. Okay, we got one guy. Dodge his ult. Kite around like this. Oh no, Ash. Okay, he missed his ult. That's something at least. Use my E to slow like this, so he can't chase me. But we're still losing the fights, which are not good. But Ash got hooked, so we want to get this one now. Fourth one. So we will have the soul, which should make our team fighting much better. Both one, let's go. I have a lot of gold, I'm gonna put some wards here so I can see where they're going. Pop this plant as well. And pop this plant so they won't have any vision whatsoever. Everything is coming here. And he's down. That's why if you clear out the vision then they will be forced to face check. Wait, use this flash? Strange, but we got the ocean soul, we just OP one. Oh, that's not good. You don't want to be within range of Darius ever, especially not a fed one. They can do the Baron if we all die. We have this one now. Why was she ult me? That's weird. Well, that's the ward here. Okay. Okay, I really want to base right now. Poke him like this. Lux works really well with an Ashe because all the slows makes it easier for you to hit your skill shot, so you can just keep kiting champions, melee champions like Darius, who has no built-in mobility. Alright, I have a lot of gold, just letting my team know. Thing is, when there are that many bot, we can just go Baron, but our jungle is also bot side. I'm gonna sell this one, I don't need it anymore. Prioritize vision. Oh, he doesn't have his ult up. That's very risky. We need... I'm not within range to ult just yet. Oh, they got... Wait, what? How did they get... That's weird, okay. Okay, great. We We need to end this game though. Cause Lux is strong, but she's not the strongest champ late game. So eventually they will catch up in XP and gold. I want the blue buff though. So I can spam my abilities and constantly peel allies with my shield and roots. Alright, I need a bit more for my watch staff. Let's stop watching Darius. It's important you keep note of what the enemy teams are buying. Cause I know he can counter my ult with it. Oh, he missed all, that's not good. There we go, so much burst. Let's get these guys. We can get this one. Vi is down, so this should be pretty safe. If my jungler is good at smiting, that is, because Heimerdinger can use his empower W. Okay, he wasted his ult. I have my ult up soon as well, so I can burst somebody if they come. Just gonna block it here from the side. There we go. Secured the Baron. I have my voice staff as well, so I'm insanely strong right now. So this will probably be the final push, so I buy this elixir as well, just for the bonus damage. And then we just CTS 5 mid. Okay, Trinima is dead. Just leave him be. We can still do it as 4 though. Then we need to reset everybody and then we group as 5 so we don't waste the Baron. Okay. Interesting. Okay, there we go. So much damage. Get this guy as well. There we go. Just one shot him with my Q. Can get the other guy. Oh, it's a really nice snipe. There we go. We just need the inhibitor now. We can possibly end as well. Let's see. This makes Lux really good with these types of teams because you can constantly peel your allies. With the shields and root. So it's impossible to kill them. Just attack this one. We need the ADC to attack it. Just applying the anti-healing on Darius so he dies. Anyway, that was the Lux video, so I hope this one was helpful and thanks so much for watching and see you guys in the next video.